Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, let's talk about Power Query. You may be familiar with just clicking around the UI a little bit, but how do you level up your skills to get better at all of those data transformations that are available? That's what I want to talk about in this video. Let's go. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, Power Query. You may be a little bit familiar with it, but there is a ton of power inside of Power Query for data transformations and just doing crazy things to help get your data in the shape that you need it. Massage that data. We like to do that here on Guy in a Cube. Before I get into the resources that are available for you to learn more, I want to start off with a maxim that Matthew Roche came up with. We've talked about it before here on Guy in a Cube if you've hung out in our live streams that are every Saturday morning. And this is the concept of where to do your data transformations. You should do your data transformations as far upstream as possible and as far downstream as necessary. So push as much back to the data source that you can. Power Query would be the next logical step. And then if you have to, do it in the data model and in DAX if you have no other option. So with that in mind, let's go through different resources that are available for you. If you're just starting out, I just want to highlight that most beginning Power BI type training is going to include introduction into Power Query. I don't know of a lot of just beginner training that's available for you. If you do know of other specific Power Query beginner training, talk about it in the comments below. So first thing I'm going to point you to is just the Microsoft Learn area for Power BI. If you're just getting started with Power BI or Power Query or whatever, great place to go begin your journey. Next, I'm just going to point you to our training here on Guy in a Cube. Our Power BI Blueprint course does cover introduction to Power Query. So we do spend some time in there, talk about some of the concepts like query folding, things of that nature. Check that out if you haven't already. Also, I'll point you to Ruth Pazuelo's course on Power Query. This is over at her Curbal website. That is another course you can do to get into Power Query itself, start looking at some of the connectors and going from there. All right, you've started with Power Query. You're leveling up a little bit. Let's talk about some things to get you there when you're at that middle stage. So one thing I'm going to point you to is a video series that Alex Powers did on his YouTube channel. This is a 30 days to query folding challenge. This is a great video series. So 30 days of just different techniques, really understanding query folding and that concept of query folding. And if you don't even know what I'm talking about when I say query folding, definitely check this out. It will help you in your journey. Also, Gil Raviv had a book that talks about combining data and just using all the transformations for Power Query in Excel and in Power BI. Did you know Power Query is in Excel? It is. So check out Gil Raviv's book. This is a good kind of middle ground where it'll cover a lot of great concepts for Power Query that's applicable to both Excel and Power BI. And then I'll point you to a course called Power Query Academy. It's over on SkillWave. This is something that was put together by Matt Allington and a few other folks. So this will cover a lot of great concepts on Power Query as well. So it's just another course that's available for you. All right, we're kicking it up a gear. There's a lot of nuances that can happen inside of Power Query that can blow your mind. While the UI is a great place to start, if you get into the M script and actually into the M syntax and the functions that are available for you in Power Query, you can do amazing things. So where do you go to even learn about that stuff? There's a couple of blogs I want to point you to. One is Imke Feldmann. Her blog goes through a lot of different concepts, but she does a lot of Power Query items as well and looks at transformations and M script, all that kind of stuff. So check out her blog for sure. Also, Chris Webb has been doing a ton of Power Query stuff at advanced levels, looking at specific functions, performance, how all of these things come together. So absolutely check out Chris Webb's blog as well if you're not. Matt Allington and his company over Accelerator BI also has a ton of great Power Query content as well. So that is another thing in my toolkit that I take a look at. And again, thinking of that advanced level, so talking about Ruth Pazuelo again on the Curbal website, she has a course going through the M language itself. So these are the functions. This is the M syntax that you can go and do advanced concepts inside of Power Query beyond what the UI can do for you. And then the last thing I'll just point you to is the M language reference. This is where you can go look up where those functions are and what you can do with them and start putting those pieces together to just take it to the absolute max level. All of these resources together will help you in your Power Query journey to train and know and learn Power Query to help you in your data transformation. All right, I want to hand this over to you. Were those resources helpful for you? Did you maybe know about some some of them. Maybe some of them are new to you. Let me know in the comments below. Also, if you have other resources that you're using, let me know about those as well. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.